Good afternoon and happy Inktober. It's day 18 and today's prompt is scrape. I think this is the hardest prompt so far this year. So initially my head went to the motion of scrape, you know, like I tried to draw a picture of it, but like if you put paint down or ink on a bit of paper and then you scraped it with like a card or something, and that was the motion. But then I was trying to think, well, that's not using the prompt to try and create something. That's just the act of scraping. So I thought about it for literally since I saw this prompt. I've thought about this for weeks and on and off. And I was just like, well, the motion isn't actually like creating something. So at the end of all of that, I just went to hands scraping along a surface. Like, I thought about doing a knife or something, and I was like, well, that's not really scraping. Like, the only thing that I can really think of when it comes to scrape is, like, fingernails scraping across something. So I just really quickly just got in the position that I thought I would kind of like want, as in just like a silhouette kind of a person just scraping something, really just scraping their fingernails across a bit of wood. And you know, it wasn't supposed to be super dark. It was literally the only thing that I could really come up with. I'll be really interested to see what everyone else can come up with for this one, because I found this one so difficult. And yeah, I just popped myself in that position and I got my little sister to take a photo, and I sort of used myself as a reference. I changed it up a bit, like I don't have long hair. I used it as a really vague reference. But yeah, what I came up with for this one was really simple. I wanted it to be a relatively fast one. I think the last one, the wave, was very detailed. And I've done quite a few that have been really quite detailed, quite big pieces, and I just wanted to simplify it a little bit because, you know, there is Inktober. I have to keep reminding myself that they're not supposed to be finished pieces. It's a sketchbook and it's an art challenge at the end of the day. So yeah, at the end of it, I just did a kind of like just a woman, not necessarily trapped, there's no real meaning to it whatsoever, just the act of scraping fingernails across a piece of wood. That was all I could really think of. Scrape is such a difficult prompt, I think. I used the same method as I have with all the others, which is I just went in with the dip pen with, I think it's the general size nib, so it's quite a big nib. I went through all of the outlines and then I rubbed out the pencil sketch underneath. I actually left it a proper amount of time so that when I rubbed it out with the kneaded eraser, none of the ink actually smudged. Usually it really smudges. I'm used to fineliners, like my Faber-Castell pit fineliners, and they're India ink too, but they dry so much faster, whereas actual India ink just takes so long to dry, and I'm really not used to that, so that's why I tend to keep smudging them. I used a slightly darker skin tone for this one as well, mostly because I haven't actually tried that yet. I found with India ink, I've just found it a lot more difficult to try and do darker skin tones and actually leave some kind of light and highlight there, and I thought this would be an easier way to test it than doing something like a face, but that's definitely something I want to do more in future. I also knew that I wanted the background to be white, so the easiest way to get a good bit of contrast in there really was either having the skin being light and the hair dark, or the skin being darker and the hair lighter. So that's the one that I went for. I, you know, it kind of combined both things that I wanted to do. For the fingernails, I needed a little bit of like an action of scrape there, but I did go a little bit overboard in this bit. I did so much scraping that I guess it looks a little bit more like a wood grain kind of texture. It wasn't supposed to be. What happened was, I think there was a tiny little bit of ink that splashed and I just kind of went overboard and I just absolutely covered it. The Chinese calligraphy brush that I'm using, it's non-synthetic, it's natural hair. And it holds so much liquid that I just find it so easy to splash everywhere. And I managed to control it for the skin tone and the hair area, but I think when I got to the hands, it just splashed a tiny bit. This is how this one looks. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like it. Make sure you're subscribed for the next day. Bye-bye.